I'm excited this morning that we're going to be talking about Aladdin. And those of you that have seen the movie Aladdin know that it's a kid's story, so that's the drama for the kids. But the principles are something every one of us as adults could learn from, could hear from, could benefit from. And I think that it's very important that you sitting here this morning, yes, pay attention to the drama, I know the kids will, but listen to what I'm going to talk to you about today and what I'm going to preach and what I'm going to say. In the movie Aladdin, it's a story of a young man who basically falls in love for a young girl, but then goes about the wrong way of trying to win her over. And even though we're concentrating on princesses this month, these 4 weeks, this story is more about a prince. A young man that becomes a prince, but Jasmine is the focal point because of the prince's stories. But Aladdin goes about it all wrong. In Proverbs chapter 31, verse 30, the Word of God says this: charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting. Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting. Now, what I want you to realize is that where we're getting with this is, you might be a charmful person, but you never know, they could be putting you on. They might not be who they're acting like they are. You can meet a beautiful person, but know this, that if your attraction is to beauty, beauty goes away. In the story of Aladdin, we have a young man that believes that it's all about charm, it's all about looks, it's all about money, this, that, and the other. He's going to find out the hard way that it's not. But I want to ask you about you this morning. What most matters to you? Your character or your appearance? Is how you look more important to you than how you are? There are people in this world that will do whatever it takes to get what they want. What are you willing to do to get what you most want? What price are you willing to pay to look a certain way? Now, the world is full of people who do anything and spend anything to change their appearance, to try to impress people themselves and then somebody else. And in this country, it's a problem. In 2012, Americans spent $10 billion on plastic surgery. $10 billion with the B on plastic surgery. There was over 10 million plastic surgery procedures last year. When in 1997, there was only 2 million. It's exploded. People trying to give an appearance of something that they're not. And those who can't afford plastic surgery do a different kind of transformation every morning in the mirror. Last year, women in the United States spent $8 billion on makeup. $8 billion. That's more than some countries have. Ladies spent $12 billion on perfumes and lotions and sprays and body products. $12 billion trying to get rid of the odorless.
$20 billion.
American men spent doesn't cost any money to fix your character, your integrity, and your attitude. That's absolutely free. And it doesn't cost any money to fall in love. It doesn't cost any money to fall in love. And I want you to see a young princess who cares more about love than anything else.
Oh my goodness! I've never been so insulted in my entire life! Prince Upton, what's wrong? What's wrong? You love Mary Heard! What happened? Jasmine?
Yes, Father? I didn't want to marry him.
Jasmine, the law says that by the way for sure that you need to be married and you need to marry a prince.
I know, Father, but I want to marry someone for love, not just some prince that I don't even know.
Jasmine, it's not just the law, but I'm not going to be around for very long. And I need to know you can take care of, provide it for.
And I understand that, Father, but love to me means everything. Just someone that I have to marry, and I don't know. It's just, it doesn't mean nothing to me. Love means everything to me.
What does love have to do with it?
Oh my gosh, Father, you don't understand. I can't. Ugh.
God forbid you should have it.
My liege. How can I best service my liege?
She says suitor's business. Jasmine, you've been married only 3 days. It's very appropriate.
Maybe I can come up with a divine solution for our problem.
We could be a team, you and I.
A team?
We And then after that, you can live in the palace.
Big old bruise here. And you know what? When
Caleb on Tuesday or Wednesday, and the report, you know how there's a guy and a lady talking on Caleb, the Christian radio station. The guy said that he had read somewhere that when they asked married women, what do you most love about your husband, what's the biggest character trait, and the biggest, most important thing, they said that he fixes things around their house, that he takes care of his house. That's the number one thing that they love. So I was excited all week. I'm like, yeah, my wife be loving me because I'm fixing things and this, that, and the other. It didn't work. But anyway, for those of you men that are married, you need to take care of your house. You need to clean up. You need to fix it up. You need to make sure things are working. And for those of you single guys, you need to go to Fresno Community College and take a handyman's class if you want to get married. But love. Jacob was willing to work 7 years. And people, if you follow the story there, if you keep going to chapter 29 and 20 and 30, you will see that he ends up working 14 years for the woman he loved. Some of you men need to be reminded of how much you love her. Things are changing in our society. People aren't getting married for love anymore. These are the top 5 reasons that people get married, according to Google. I Googled it. And I want you to see the top 5 reasons. The number one reason that people get married nowadays is to get out of their parents' home. I don't want to get out of my parents' home. Number 2 is, it seems like the next logical step for me to take after school. Number 3 is, I want to fix the other person. They have issues. And that, some of us men know amen. We can say amen to that. Why are you trying to fix it? Number 4, this is where the Christians come in. I got married because I didn't want to sin. Well. And number 5 was, I don't want to be alone. Love isn't even in the top 5 reasons why people get married. But love should matter. Love is important. The Bible dedicates a whole chapter in 1 Corinthians 13. And speaking about love, the Bible says love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it isn't proud, it doesn't dishonor the other. It's not self-centered, it's not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, it always trusts, it always hopes, and it will always persevere. Love will never fail. So here we have a young princess who wants to fall in love. The young man she's interested in falls in love with her. You kind of see the little thing. He wants to build a team, take her away, show her a whole new world. And then the enemy steps in and says, this is the easy way. This is how you do it. He tells him, I have a lamp. And in this lamp is this magic that'll make her fall in love with you. But I can't get the lamp because I'm evil. But you are good and kind-hearted, so you can get the lamp. And we know he's good and kind-hearted because he saves a complete stranger. He says, I don't think that eating is a crime. I don't think being hungry is a crime. So he has a choice. Is he going to try to win her over with love? Or is he going to take the evil Jafar's shortcut to happiness? So he goes off in search of a treasure. Okay, I'm moving. You got to find this lamp. But make sure you don't touch anything. Jafar was clear on that. And I know you, little greedy little monkey. Yeah, you're probably right. Man, why does he even want this lamp? You think so? Nah, I don't know. Hey, be careful. We don't know what's in here. Watch it now. Looks like it's it. But no! Abu, stop! Abu, don't touch anything! I thought I made that clear. Wait, this has to be. No, don't touch it! Look, there's something great on it. I'm gonna scrub it out. Thank you.
Because that's the rule. You can't ask more wishes. Now, there are some permissions to those three wishes. Three things I cannot do, will not do, but cannot do most importantly. I can't kill somebody, so don't ask. Okay? I can't
bring somebody back from the dead.
No, brother.
about is big TV, not passionate about those things, but passionate about something that is good, like maybe helping the poor, like maybe serving the elderly, maybe volunteering and putting up stuff at church for a drama, maybe helping out at the church. A passion for life is the number one trait. And let me tell you something, it's free. You don't have to pay for that. Number two is confidence. He's a confident person. He's confident in what he's doing. Now, don't confuse that with arrogance. Arrogance is high on the hated list. But confidence is something that they're looking for in a man, that he's confident about what he's doing. I'm going to tell you something. It is attractive when a person loves God and there's nothing that can change their mind. That they know that God is real and that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, and they're confident about that and they live what they believe. That's attractive. Guess what? It's free. Number three is respect. You don't have to pay money to be respectful. You don't have to pay money to learn how to be respectful. Number four and five are intellect and humor. Intellect and humor. Now, all of these are free. You don't need no magic genie. You don't need a magic pill. You don't need to take a shortcut. These are things that, as I told you earlier, the Bible says you can continue to work on. Intellect and humor. I watched this NBA basketball player when they're being interviewed, and they have these fake reading glasses on. And they put on these fake reading glasses, and some of them wear them, and they don't even have a lens. And I wonder, are they trying to be funny? Well, now that I know this, they must have read the same report. They're knowing that they can attract people by being intellectual and being humorous. Some of you, you're not very smart. Go get some fake glasses. Fake it till you make it. That would be wrong. We're talking today about being real. There are a lot of things that are free. It's a lifelong process that you will build yourself into the person God intended you to be. You may not be that person yet, but you can get there. Be careful. There's a lot of vanity in this world. People worshiping the fashions, worshiping material things, worshiping money, worshiping everything except God. When Jesus said in Matthew chapter 4, verse 10, when the devil said, I'll give you everything. I'll give you all the kingdoms of the world. Jesus said, it is written in the law, worship the Lord your God only. Not worship your house, your clothes, yourself. We need to be careful. We don't fall in that trap. And Aladdin has fallen into that trap. You spend too much money on your appearance, you could be in danger of looking a little vain. So be careful. Be careful. Modesty. Be moderate. Be moderate in your appearance. Work on the inside, not the outside. Be who God created you to be. I told you last week, I read your verse in the Bible that says, God, everything that God made is good. I'm glad Rosario was here last week. Everything God made is good. So be what God made you. And work on it and get better. And get better at being the person that God made you. So here we have Aladdin. He took Jafar's way out. He went and he found the lamp. And now he's coming to win Jasmine, the princess, with trickery, with shortcuts and shenanigans. I don't think it's going to work. He turned him into Prince Ali.
Prince Ali, Prince Ali, Prince Ali.
everything that any princess would ever want.
He is not worthy of our princess. I should know better.
Give him a chance to for a real very short time, then.
I'm totally against this, sire.
Watch.
Give him a chance.
I'll show you
give him, just give him a chance.
No way.
I think you should just give him a chance.
It's not working.
Princess Jasmine, it is I, Prince Ali Abou.
What do you want?
I'm here to request your hand in marriage.
My hand? In marriage?
Yes.
No, I don't think so.
But why not? Look at me. I'm everything anyone would ever want.
Do you think by coming to my palace with that parade and everything is going to win my heart over?
Wasn't it great?
No, it wasn't great because I'm a princess and I can already do all that.
But I'm like, I have all the people, the gold, the money, the power.
Gold? Power? Is that what you think it's all about? Just to win my heart over with money?
You look fit. You must have been running through my mind all day long.
I look fit? I think you actually have been seeing a lot of princesses to use that line.
Well, if loving you is wrong, I don't want to be right.
You don't want to be right?
Come on, princess. Just give me a chance. I'll show you.
You'll show me? And what can you think you can show me?
I can show you the world.
The world?
Yes, if only you'd come with me.
If I go with you?
Yes. Do you trust me?
Do I trust you?
Do you trust me?
Have we met before?
I'm sure we've never met before.
Because you remind me of somebody that I met in the marketplace.
Marketplace? No, I've never even been there myself. I have servants to go to the marketplace for me. I have servants for my servants to go to the marketplace. But
well, then, you must be right.
Come on, we can be a team.
A team?
A team, you and I.
Me and you.
Yes, do you trust me?
Yes, I do. Let me go down.
In closing, let me just say this.
honesty is probably the easiest thing that you could work on right now. The Bible says in Luke 16:10, whoever can be trusted with very little can also be trusted with very much. But whoever is dishonest with very little will be dishonest with very much. So I want to tell you this morning that honesty and dishonesty is the beginning of character. If you can tell the truth, Aladdin was lying because Jafar was telling him that's how he's going to win the princess. But we know that's not the way to do it. When he finally told her the truth, he was able to win her over. Your actions will tell us if you are honest in your heart or not. Your actions are a reflection of your faith. It is a reflection of who you are on the inside. The Bible teaches, Isaiah 59:13, that lies come from the heart. So you got to make sure that your heart is right. Maybe that's why there's so much divorce, people lying to each other about who they are, and they're not who they say they are. In Proverbs chapter 6, verse 16 through 19, the Bible says that God hates lies and a false witness. Be who God made you to be, quit faking it till you make it. We all know that the truth is what sets us free. In Aladdin's case, it worked. When he finally told her who he really was, she said, I love him. And she didn't care where he came from, that he was from the market, he was from the street. And then because of that truth, Jafar was destroyed. So I want to tell you this morning. Quit pretending to be something you're not. Quit acting to be, and quit transforming yourself into what you're not. Start working on your character. Start working on integrity, and start working on honesty. Let's pray.